Good morning, everyone. Happy New Year and welcome to the January Loukoumi Good Deed of the Month Zoom. Can everybody hear me? Can you guys hear me? Yeah, I see hands raised. That means yes. Okay, great. Well, Happy New Year. Welcome. We're here live at the Anne Hutchinson School in Eastchester, New York with some great kids from the Student Council. Today, we're going to be talking about our January project, which is helping nursing homes, which is very important. But before we get to that, we wanted to do a recap of our December project for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. As you know, we sponsor the Loukoumi Foundation Treatment Room at St. Jude, sponsored by kids' donations. Kids make a card and then donate $1 or more for the Loukoumi Foundation Treatment Room. And because of your donations, we are now over $86,000 raised for that treatment room. So thank you so much. It's still not too late to participate. I know the students here at Anne Hutch are going to be working on that project this month. And we have a wonderful young lady that would like to speak to us. Her name is Stella, and she has a great project that she'd like to share with us. Stella, you want to come?
So for my birthday, I decided instead of doing all these goodie bags for my class, I decided to donate money and raise money for the St. Jude's Hospital. So for the goodie bag, we made cards for the holidays for the children. And we have little Christmas trees on the front. And we wrote like a nice note in the middle, like, "Dear friend, I hope you have a wonderful holiday. And I hope you are doing well. Hope you think bright thoughts. Be strong, happy, and hopeful." And then I would sign my name at the end. So we raised about $605, and it was really generous for all the students in my class to donate. And I would also like to thank everybody in my family for also halfway joining that opportunity.
Wow, thank you so much, Stella. When was your birthday?
December 19th.
Oh, happy late birthday.
Thank you.
Yeah. That's great. So as you can see, there's so many ways to do good deeds. It doesn't have to be just making a card. You know, Stella took it to the next level. And she actually, as she said, instead of birthday gifts, she had people donate money to the St. Jude Project. And you can create a page on the St. Jude website. It's fundraising.stjude.org/Loukoumi, which is the website. So thank you. That was wonderful to hear. So now we'll go to our January Good Deed of the Month. And we started a program this year with the Anne Hutchinson School called Adopt a Nursing Home. And we wanted to talk to you about helping nursing home residents and not just doing one thing for nursing home residents, but we want to get to know some of these residents. We want to do things for them several times a year because they are very lonely, especially coming out of COVID. And they all they want to do is they want to, you know, hear from you and see you and you know, just be cheered up and know that they have friends out there. So as part of this Adopt a Nursing Home program, the Anne Hutchinson students have visited the nursing home a couple of times already. So we have some of the students here. We have our Loukoumi Kids Club board members who are representing the school. We have Anthony and Maggie here, and I'll pivot the laptop there. So say hi, Anthony and Maggie.
Hi.
So do you guys want to say what we did on Make a Difference Day? Okay.
So for Make a Difference Day, it started out where we met up in a place at Queens and we made candy bags and goodie bags and we made cards for the nursing home. And then we did that for a couple hours and then we went over to the nursing home. And we gave out the cards and the goodie bags, and then we had some people perform at the nursing home. I think Vivian and Hudson performed, and Lorenzo performed.
Yeah. So Lorenzo, what did you perform?
I played "Can't Help Falling in Love" on the alto saxophone for the nursing home, and we do it once a year.
So you did like a little show for them.
Yeah.
And how about Vivian, what did you do?
I played "That's Amore" on the violin, and it was really good to see the smiles on their faces when I played.
And Hudson?
See Hudson here? I don't really remember what the name was, but I played a song on the cello, and it was just really great to see how they all felt afterwards.
Exactly. You did a great job. I was there. And how did it make you feel afterwards?
It made me feel like pretty good because like I was helping other people with like maybe if they're like bored because they didn't look bored. They were watching a movie when we came in, but yeah, it just made me feel good to know that they were very happy afterwards.
Mm-hmm. And then Vivian, around the holidays, we went back to the nursing home. The one we're working with in Tuckahoe is the Fountains at Riverview. And what did we do right before the holidays?
We went to the Fountains at Riverview Nursing Home with some of the Anne Hutch chorus, and we sang Christmas carols for them.
Right. And how was that?
That was really fun.
It was fun, right? They were all singing along. And we also have Aiden here. And Aiden, you want to say hello?
Hi.
Yeah. And do you want to talk about, you know, any of the nursing home projects that we're doing, or are you looking forward to doing more projects? We're going to do a lot of more projects with the nursing home. Does anybody have any other ideas of things we can do for the nursing home residents? Maggie, do you have any ideas?
So I was thinking maybe in your schools we could do more fundraisers to like help more of the nursing homes, and basically like like every time you do a good deed in your school you would get like maybe a little sticker and like and it would say like you did a good job to like spread to like reward you for doing a good deed maybe.
Yeah, there's so many things. There's really, go ahead.
Yeah, I was just going to say that I like the performing and the cards giving, and I think that maybe we can do, like, more of the performing, because I think it made them very happy to hear the performances, and I can, like, as we were walking out, I could hear them, like, smiling and laughing.
Yeah, absolutely, because, you know, you got to realize it's a long day for them. It's lonely. Yeah. They wait for people to come visit them, and they love seeing you, and these things can be done in person, or they can also be done virtually. Did you have a question? Yeah.
Maybe we could like go over there and play games with them. Because I remember my great grandpa, I used to play like lots of checkers with him.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes I'd go to other people around his nursing home and I'd play some stuff with them, and it made them really happy.
Oh, that's great. That's all great ideas. We have a video that we want to show you about a very special girl, but before we do that, we want to also go to a few schools around the world and ask them about what they've been doing with the name of the nursing home that they've been benefiting and also what they've been doing. So let's go first to Victoria Garcia at Our Lady of Grace School. And Victoria, are you there?
Good morning, everyone. My name is Victoria Garcia, and I am a proud third grade student at Our Lady of Grace School, located in the Bronx, New York. I am so happy to share with you some of the things that our school has done to support the amazing residents of nursing homes in our local community. In the past, our students have sung Christmas carols and delivered holiday cards to the residents of the Laconia Nursing Home, located a few blocks from our school. It is always so nice to brighten up the spirits during the holiday season. More recently, our school partnered with the wonderful Three Wishes for Ruby's Residents organization as part of the Make a Difference Day. Students from our school collected Amazon wishlist items for the residents of the ArchCare St. Vincent de Paul Nursing Home and Rehabilitation Facility in the Bronx. We presented the items and the balloons to the residents, and it was a memorable experience for all involved. Some of the items we collected included puzzles, blankets, knitting supplies, and board games. I hope that these items are still bringing joy today. Our school is very much looking forward to participating in the Good Deed of the Month project, and we are eager to help so many seniors in our community who have done so much for us. Have a blessed day, everyone.
Thank you, Victoria. And thank you to everybody. Hello, Principal Rich Helmrich. Great job that you guys are all doing at Our Lady of Grace in the Bronx. And we will hear more about Three Wishes for Ruby's Residence shortly. For now, though, let's go to Gander, Newfoundland, Canada, in the northern tip of Canada, to hear from Sydney and what that school has done at Gander Elementary School for their local nursing home. Sydney, are you there? Sydney? I just got a text from their school. Well, why don't we, while we're waiting for Sydney, let's go to Deerfield, Illinois, to the Hellenic American Academy, where Gregory Vranis is going to tell us about what they've done at their school. Gregory, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hi, Gregory. Good morning. Good morning. I know it's a little earlier there for you. It's an hour earlier than here in New York, but welcome. So why don't you tell us what you've done for your local nursing home?
The Academy has included the Greek American Rehabilitation and Care Center for several years as part of their Good Deed bus tour. During my fourth and fifth grade years, I took part in the Loukoumi bus program by performing small skits and songs for the residents at the nursing home, along with my classmates. And all the kids and staff of my school would donate money and or purchase items on the residents' wish lists. This year, we all wrote encouraging post-it notes and that were placed on the residents' doors. My favorite memory of my visit was acting out a play that with my friends that we did there for a show and putting smiles on the residents' faces. It's very important to give back to my generation, to give back to the past generations who have given so much to make positive changes in the world, including passing on the Hellenic faith and culture, making me who I am today.
Well, great. Well, thank you, Gregory, and thank you to everyone at the Hellenic American Academy. Let's check back in with Sydney. Sydney, are you there from Gander? I think they're having some technical difficulties. So why don't we now go to our featured video and then we can come back at the end. We heard Victoria mention Three Wishes for Ruby's Residence, which is a great organization that we work with. Anthony and Maggie, you've met Ruby on some of our Zoom calls. Yes. That we've had, our board Zoom calls. So Ruby is an incredible young woman from Arkansas. She's only 13 years old. And she started an organization to help nursing homes where she gives them wishes. She asks them for small wishes of things that they would like, and then she fulfills those wishes. Ruby was recently picked by CNN to be the Kid Wonder of the Year. She's also won the Princess Diana Award. And recently, just last week, she was featured on a CBS News special, and we have that clip to share with you now. So let me share the screen. And I'd love to show you the gift, Kindness Goes Viral by Steve Hartman, that aired on CBS last week.
In a small town in northwest Arkansas, a 15-year-old high school freshman named Ruby Chitsey is making her mark on the cheer team. She's also spreading her own brand of cheer.
Let me give you a hug.
To residents at local nursing homes.
I can connect to them just as much as I do a kid my age, so I don't really see that age difference in them, and I'm just so glad that they're my friends and that I can, you know, talk to them.
But Ruby does much more than chat them up.
Got your shirt.
She lifts them up with deceptively simple.
It's really pretty outside.
But remarkably profound. Yeah. Acts of kindness.
Have a good day, sweetie.
The idea began bubbling when the shy 10-year-old was looking for something to call her own.
When I was younger, I didn't really have any hobbies, and it was kind of difficult to make friends when you don't have any hobbies, you don't go out, and you're not really good at anything. So, you know, kindness was my hobby.
When we first met her 4 years ago, Ruby liked going to work with her mom. Amanda is a nurse who travels to several nursing homes in the area. And it was on one of those visits that Ruby started going up to residents with her notepad.
If you could have any three things, what would they be? What would you want?
She came up with this idea, these questions?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. With the intention of what?
I don't think she had an intention, really.
Ruby told us she was simply curious what the seniors would say.
Were you surprised?
Yes, I was very surprised. I thought people would say, like, money, houses, Lamborghini.
But instead, here's what she got. Electric razor. new shoes, Vienna sausage. For some reason, a lot of people asked for Vienna sausage and other really basic items.
Like, that's all they wanted. And I really decided that I needed to do something.
So she started Three Wishes for Ruby's Residence.
I'm gonna sit right beside you.
While her mom was caring for patients,
cheese,
Ruby went room to room.
I love cheese.
I do too.
Jotting down wishes.
Avocados.
And then setting out to grant those wishes.
Thank you, sweetheart.
You're welcome. It really lifts you. It really does.
On this day, she came back with a wheelchair full of sausages and other grocery items.
Watermelon and oranges.
But behind it, that fundamental connection she has.
It's okay.
Thank you so much.
I mean, they were my age 60 years ago. There's no exactly difference.
You know, you could change the world. Have you thought about that?
Yes. It's like in a lot chance. But I would like just to inspire people.
Is there any secret to being 102?
I watched my weight. I watched my kind of diet.
Ruby's inspiration, her gift, has become a national movement to make wishes come true for seniors she feels have been neglected for far too long.
At first, we were just in Harrison, and it was just a little small thing. We went to 5 nursing homes, and now we serve hundreds of nursing homes, and every year we give out thousands of wishes.
Besides Three Wishes in Arkansas, a nonprofit run by Amanda and Ruby, there are now programs for kids to visit nursing homes in more than 40 states. There are also programs to send letters to seniors and bring them cats who need homes. Ruby loves cats.
Other people have seen what she's done and has mimicked that in so many different ways. We've had people in New York City that give different nursing homes, and folks from Gander, Newfoundland did some wishes out there. And so when they see Ruby doing that, I think a light bulb kind of goes off, like, oh, you know, I can do that too. And it's not really that hard.
At least it wasn't that hard till COVID hit. Ruby was shut out of nursing homes. It was tough on her and on her many old friends.
They're just locked in there. It's like a cage almost.
That's our little Miss Ruby.
I'll open her.
But Ruby waited it out, came back stronger than ever.
Thank you, God, for daily bread.
And has now gained international attention.
I have the Princess Diana Award, which is probably my biggest award yet. This is a certificate of recognition.
In her bedroom, a wall of awards. But accolades aside, what still brings Ruby and the seniors the most joy is that human touch.
Hey.
Hey.
How have you been?
How are you?
I'm good. Let me give you a hug.
She just glows. Just first time I ever laid eyes on her. She was just, you know, sparkling all over with love.
I've been going there my entire life. I grew up with them. They watched me grow up. They're just such great people. They have so much history behind them and so much knowledge and power.
Whether she realizes it or not, Ruby is sending a message other kids are hearing, that to be remembered, to be cherished, especially by a child, is what our seniors are truly hungry for. And that is what Ruby brings every time she sets foot in a nursing home.
As we've seen, when a single act of kindness goes viral, it can have a ripple effect. So we're hoping to start a wave right now. Sometime this week, do an act of kindness and post a picture or video using the hashtag #KindnessGoesViral. And let's see what we can do together.
Thank you.
So, as you can see, this was incredible what Ruby's done, and she's done it all over the country. And what we did also for Make a Difference Day, it doesn't have to be a big project. What we did with many schools around the country is a project with Post-it notes. This, as you know, is a Post-it note. And all the kids did was design the Post-it note. And then you, all of a sudden, you have hundreds of Post-it notes, and they would put them on the doors of residents. They would put them on a big bulletin board, and that's something that Ruby inspired all of us to do. So as you can see, there's so many things that you can do for nursing homes. So for this month, our project is not anything specific of what to do, but just to do something for your local nursing home. Identify a local nursing home, many of you already have, and do something this month to cheer them up, whether it's making post-it notes or cards or bringing cookies over there or as Hudson said, playing games with them, or as Anthony said and all of you kids did on Make a Difference Day, go and do a performance, you know, sing songs, do a show, anything that can cheer them up, because a little kindness goes a long, long way, and no good deed is too small. So, and then please let us know what you do for that local nursing home. Send us pictures, send us videos so that we can share it with our Loukoumi Foundation community all around the world. Thank you all for listening. Again, Happy New Year. We're looking forward to a great new year of good deeds with our Adopt a Nursing Home program and other projects. So before we go, just want everybody to say goodbye.
Bye.
Goodbye, guys. Bye. This side too?
Bye.
Okay. Also, I just want to thank Dr. Nick Keene for welcoming us here, and Felicia Muldari and everyone else from the Anne Hutchinson School. It was great to have you all here. Before we go, just want to check in. Is Sydney here? Or is did Sydney...
Yeah.
Oh, there you are, Sydney. Okay, so let's end the Zoom with hearing about the good deeds that you have done in Gander, Newfoundland, Canada.
Good morning. During the last 3 years at Gander Elementary, we have worked on several different projects for seniors. We have put together care packages, which included snacks, books, snacks, winter gloves, and scarves, DVDs, and CDs, to name a few. We also put together Halloween treat bags, and we visit two different seniors' homes in Gander during our Good Deeds bus tour, Worms Manor and Golden Years Estates. We've also baked muffins for seniors and made caring cards for them as well. Thank you.
That's great. Thank you so much, Sydney. And I look forward to seeing you in May when we come up to Gander and host the Good Deed of the Month Zoom from your school. So keep up the great work. So everyone, again, thank you for a great start to the year. We wish you all the best. Keep doing good deeds and go out and reach out to those nursing home residents. They will love it, and then you will love it as well, because you'll feel great doing it. So thanks again, everyone. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you next month. Take care.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.